It's Elias, the city hall runs on excellency. When it comes to the children of the city, full benefits from one of the best educational systems in Israel today.
Ευχαριστούμε θερμά για την παρουσία σας εδώ, τους νέους αδελφούς μας από το Ισραήλ. Τη σχέση φιλίας και συνεργασίας που χαρακτηρίζουν...
Ρωτάει ορεποτάει σαλόν, ρουχήμ απαίν λατέκια σε σλάπ, κοιτέει λεασέρ, μπεντέρεχ, ρισμή, ετάν, για αφιέν, ετ αγιαχασία.
My presence at this podium is not simply to perform an official duty. Through it, the City Council of Paphos, reflecting the feeling of the town citizens, is declaring in this most official way its strong desire to develop bonds of friendship, cooperation, and brotherhood with a city of friendly neighborhooding country with which we are associated in so many significant ways. It is my conviction that this brotherly association between Herzliya and Paphos will be a model, a pillar of friendship and cooperation between the two cities, with their different national and cultural backgrounds in the troubled wider region of the Eastern Mediterranean and Middle East. My emerging strengths and expertise in the fields of science, economy, and culture, the local authority from different states in the region can substantially contribute to the easing of long-standing political differences and disputes. Cyprus and Israel, Paphos and Herzliya, are not accidentally meeting here today. In the course of history, the two countries have left their distinct marks on the development of civilization in the wider region and have contributed to the promotion of reflection between its people. Today, we are once again watering the tree of peaceful coexistence and harmonious cooperation with common value, principles, and the ideals of the Hebrew and Greek culture. The greatest challenge that now lies ahead of us, dear Mayor of Herzliya, is to reap the fruits of this tree for the promoting of our city and country and of the wider region. Mr. Mayor of Herzliya, my friend Moshe Fatlon, today with our associates, we are opening the road to cooperation between our municipalities and city, and the great challenge is to turn it into an avenue towards productive fraternal relations in all fields. From this podium, I will to express on behalf of the citizens of Paphos our profound respect for the history and civilization of your city and country. It is my conviction that Paphos, European Capital of Culture for 2017, and Herzliya, the Silicon Valley of Israel, may function as a bridge of communication and cooperation between Europe and the Middle East, benefiting universal culture. Με την αδελφοποίηση που γίνεται με την πόλη του Ισραήλ, αφού πριν από λίγο καιρό προηγήθηκε η αδελφοποίηση με την πόλη του Αμάν και έπεται πολύ σύντομα η επίσκεψή μας και η έναρξη των διαβουλεύσεων για να αδελφοποιηθούμε με την πόλη της Αλεξάνδρειας, τελειώνει έτσι μια πρώτη φάση, μια πρώτη προσπάθεια να χτίσουμε μια περιφερειακή συνεργασία μεταξύ πόλεων γειτονικών χωρών, αφού τα μηνύματα τα οποία παίρνουμε και μέσα από την διπλωματία και την εξωτερική πολιτική που ασκούν τα κράτη μας είναι να αναπτυχθούν στενές σχέσεις μεταξύ των κρατών και των λαών της περιοχής. Για 2.000 χρόνια τώρα, οι λαοί αυτή της περιοχής πρωταγωνιστούν. Σε αυτή την περιοχή, ο χριστιανισμός, ο ιουδαϊσμός, ο ισλαμισμός ξεκίνησαν από αυτές τις χώρες και από αυτή την περιοχή. Ήρθε η ώρα εμείς, οι λαοί αυτών των χωρών, να συνεννοηθούμε, να συνεργαστούμε για το κοινό όφελος όλων μας, για την πρόοδο και την ανάπτυξη που μπορούμε να ζήσουμε και να απολαύσουν και οι σημερινές γενιές αλλά και οι μέλουσες. Και κρατώ μόνο κάτι και παραχωρώ το βήμα. Αν είναι κάτι που έχω πάρει σε αυτή την πρώτη, τις πρώτες επαφές με την πόλη της Χερζιλίγια, το έχω πει πριν από λίγο στο γραφείο στον πρόεδρο της Βουλής, τον κύριο Σιλούρη, αλλά και με την πρέσβη, το έχουμε πει έτσι με δύο λόγια, είναι εντυπωσιακό σε αυτή την πόλη να πας να μιλάς και το 80% του χρόνου τους, των πόρων τους, τα θυσιάζουν για την παιδεία της νέας γενιάς. Η μεγάλη τους έννοια είναι τα πάρκα, τα σχολεία, η τεχνολογία, η ρομποτική και βλέπεις ανθρώπους 60, 70, 80 ετών να ασχολούνται πώς θα ευημερήσει και πώς θα μορφωθεί ένα παιδί 5 και 10 ετών. Αυτή είναι η μεγάλη επιτυχία, αυτό είναι το μεγάλο μήνυμα που εγώ θέλω να μεταδώσω, ότι μπορούμε να κερδίσουμε από αυτή την πόλη και εμείς μπορούμε να δώσουμε αυτά που ίσως λείπουν από αυτή την πόλη. Οι συνεργασίες είναι προς κοινόν όφελος και προς αυτή την κατεύθυνση θα εργαστούμε. Σας ευχαριστώ.
אני שמח לחתום כאן בפאפוס על ברית ערים תאומות בין העיר הצליה לבין פאפוס, שתי ערים שחולקות תקוות ושאיפות דומות של בניית גשרים וגשרים לעתיד טוב יותר. הרעיון העומד מאחורי המהלך הזה הוא האפשרות למפגש ישיר, חוצה גבולות ותרבויות, במגוון הנושאים והתחומים שמעסיקים את שתי הערים. תוך בניית מערכות של קשרים ביניהם. הברית הזו חשובה לכולנו, שכן הקשרים המתפתחים, חילופי המידע והביקורים ההדדיים מהווים מנוף לקירוב לבבות, להבנה ולגיוס משאבים לקידום התיירות, ההשקעות, התרבות, העסקים ועוד.
How many moments an ambassador has in a period of service in a country seeing two mayors of distinguished communities, of distinguished municipalities, signing this commitment of alliance between two cities, between two communities. I wanted to congratulate you for this inspiring event, your inspiring words, and your inspiring commitment, and if I can add the Embassy of Israel's commitment to be here for you, both the city of Herzliya and the city of Paphos, and to help you to build this bridge of friendship and alliance between your communities, between our communities, between our people. I allow myself to tell you about three visits I had to Paphos. The first one was in 1999. I came with my young family, is an Israeli tourist. That was my first visit to Cyprus, and then is when my love affair with Cyprus started. I enjoyed visiting Paphos so much, visiting the beaches, visiting the archaeological sites, visiting the mountains, visiting and meeting with people. And that was the first time when I realized how close we are, how similar we are. The second time was a few months ago, and that is not far away from here, in a very early hour of the morning, Sami, my deputy, and myself knocked on the gates of the Paphos Air Base. It was about 6:30 in the morning, and we came to welcome the Israeli aircrafts that arrived to assist Cyprus fighting the fire that was taking place here not far away from Paphos. And unfortunately, that was after that one, there was a bigger one in Solea, and we were very proud to be here to stand by our Cypriot friends fighting arm to arm with your forces against this fire, against this natural disaster. And I'm glad to say that seeing the Israeli airplanes in the sky, and I remember when the president of Cyprus came to the place where we were, and Mr. Silouris, you were there at that moment, and looking with him at the Israeli airplanes in the sky of Cyprus, fighting together against this natural disaster, that was a filming moment for me. It was an expression of how strong we are and how our alliance is beyond words. Our alliance is here, our alliance is here to stay, and our alliance is for the future. And speaking about the future, this is my third visit that I would like to mention here, and this is today's visit. Being here, speaking about cooperation, speaking about commitment of both communities, just to remind all of us that both Israel and Cyprus are the single democracies in the area. We are both struggling in a region that is in a challenging times, and we have no other way but standing one by another, working together to assure our young generation a future, to create an horizon, horizon of innovation, horizon of cultural creation, of economic opportunities, of business opportunities. And I strongly believe that in this alliance that you build today, in your commitment today, you create the foundations for this kind of cooperation to promise our young generation a better future. So all the blessings to you, all my greetings to you, and all my support. Thank you very much.
I have the honor and the privilege to address you today, both in my capacity as acting President of the Republic and as President of the House of Representatives on this special occasion, celebrating the twinning of the municipalities of Paphos and Herzliya. The ceremony marks successful conclusion of significant initiative both for Cyprus and Israel. Given the extremely crucial circumstances our region is facing, as the ambassador explained, I would like to congratulate everybody involved in materializing this goal, but especially so the two municipalities. The twinning itself highlights and enhances the existing friendly relations between our two countries, which are not limited to the government or to the parliamentary level, but also spread to the municipality framework, the continuous effort for further strengthening these relations is a result of our joint will, shared vision, and common expectations. During the last years, the deepening of the bilateral relations between Cyprus and Israel has also been reflected at parliamentary level, something for which I'm very pleased. In this context, I would like to briefly mention as points of reference the exchange of visit between my predecessor, Mr. Omiru, to Israel a few months ago, and the prior visit of His Excellency, the President of Knesset, Mr. Edelstein, to Cyprus in 2013, which included the signing of a memorandum of understanding between our two parliaments. Moreover, in March 2016, the House of Representatives hosted a meeting of three countries, the chairmen of Parliamentary Committee of Foreign Affairs from Cyprus, Greece, and Israel. Last but not least, the visit to Israel by the chairman of the Standing Committee of Foreign Affairs and European Affairs, again within 2016, and in 2012, that by the chairman of the member and the members of the Standing Committee of Finance and Budgetary Affairs. Dear friends, twinnings are initiatives that are both valuable and necessary, as they create the essential circumstances to boost our cooperation further, beyond energy and tourism, also into youth, culture, and new technologies, like the very possibilities the two municipalities explore now, given the knowledge and expertise in this field that Herzliya can export to Cyprus through its distinguished academics, businessmen, some of which are present here today.
Δήμαρχος Πέδωνας Πέδωνος προσφέρει στον αδελφό Δήμαρχο της Κεντζηλία ένα πιστό αντίγραφο της κεφαλής της Αφροδίτης, έμβλημα του Δήμου μας και συμβολικό δείγμα του ιστορικού μας παρελθόντος και της πολιτικής μας παρελθόντος.
Βετοσφέι Πάφος, Ροσιριάτ Μαρφέδων, Μανίκλε Ροσιριάτ Ερτσελία, ετέκμε κορί σελ Ροσ Ελά Αφροδίτα. Σέμεν,
σύμβολο της φιλίας και της αδερφοσύνης, της ειρήνης και της ελπίδας στην ταρακλήνια του Καλούμα.